going to die. Somebody had to be a freaking mind control ninja. That's what I say that was, just the moment I stepped open that door. Lame. So I missed out on a bunch of experience in not killing those thods. Also the discipline wand, but I'm going to be erring on the side of caution for, my alignment here. What? Just frickin' flies out of the trees? Hi, I wasn't here last time, but I totally am this time, and I'm going to one-shot your worm. Goodbye. That's why I need the plated Artila. Although I think I only have one rank of Artila now, but whatever. You can come to me. I'm not gonna be here. Stupid things. Try this again. Slow on hit should be outlawed. Journal. Since quite a few of the entries were scratched out, quite a few more were torn out, and most of the rest are clear the ramblings of a diseased mind, you don't learn too much. Best you could tell from the intact coherent entries, this ruined home belonged to an alchemist named Kyra. His alchemy, however, was a front to keep his studies of necromantic magic hidden from Shaper authorities. He spent years creating more and more powerful shades and putting them to work digging out a network of tunnels under his home. The tunnels were to be the location of his great transformation. While the journal is light on details of what this transformation would entail, whenever a mage starts tossing out terms like great transformation, nothing good is to follow. Probably not. So what, was he gonna become a lich? Oh boy. Another tunnel sequence. I dug this tunnel out of the wet earth under the house. Well, dug might not be the best word. Clawed is a more apt description. This pit was excavated by clawed creatures ripping apart the dirt and rocks free with their hands or paws. It's icy cold down here. Icicles hang from the ceiling and frost crunches underfoot. It's absolutely quiet. There's a pile of skulls in an alcove in the dirt. Many of the skulls are from unintelligent creations. More come from servals, and some are definitely human. The only reason anyone would want to collect so many skulls is necromantic magic. Though the practice is forbidden by the Shaper, some criminals secretly continue to practice. Punishment, when caught, of course, is severe. Someday I'm just gonna walk right past a pile of skulls with something, like, really good in it. Because there's just so many of them, and most of them just contain nothing but skulls. Casting takes effect. Yes, this is gonna summon some baddies for me to fight, right? Yep. Probably one from each pile, skull pile. shade, huh? Cleared off some of them. Ow. I shouldn't be using ice against them anyway. Doesn't open then? I could have sworn that would have opened the door. Did that just summon more of them? Like infinite shades to fight? Crazy. Let's not do that again. Interesting that it's there, but pesky necromancers. I want to at least get to the darn boat before I stop. Jeez, almost 4 hours. One long power session. These docks are close enough to the Donald's Isle, the next island in the chain. You could navigate the boat there yourself. Because of the quarantine, these docks are well guarded. However, the soldiers keeping watch have left. They were probably driven off by the newly energized rebels. You can enter freely. Reach the Donald docks. They have been completely abandoned. The sailors and workers have fled for far safer confines of Sanru. There's a single boat waiting at the docks. It's a small skiff you could safely pilot at the Donald's Isle, but not much farther than that. So that is the largest landmass in the Ashen Isles. It's settled for over a century. There you can find the capital of this remote province and the most powerful shaper for miles around, Lord Rahul. If anyone can make sense of the madness swirling around you, he can. Approach the docks, Greta stops you, you turn to see, it's because she is smiling. She looks happier than you've ever seen her. Shaper, she says, I want to thank you. You ask her why? Because of what we did. That Latalia, the shaper who attacked us. I know that she has done terrible things, I know that she is our enemy, but we have helped her to help the rebels, and, well, I think it was the right thing to do. Myself, I would not have had the courage to help Latalia, but you were wise enough to do what she wanted because it was a just thing to do. I feel that helping the rebels was just, and I thank you for being strong enough to see that. That's all I wanted to say. I'm ready to proceed. And I'm sure if we had brought the other guy, he'd be like, you were a stupid idiot. Why did you do that? I hate you. I'm totally going to kill you now, or something like that. Well, defended, not impossible for someone to slip in. Someone snuck in here and left a note for you. It's addressed to you by name. It hangs the nail pounded into one of the posts. It reads, heard you assist the rebels? You have given them power so that they can survive and continue in their resistance to the tyrannical power of the Shapers. I am pleased. Though I'm a Shaper by training, I see that our ways are out of date and morally wrong. They must be torn down, burned, destroyed, so a new way can be built. We are taking the first steps. A servile agent will contact you on Donald's Island and will tell you how you may serve me. Keep an eye open and take this chance when it is offered, and do not flee to the mainland. Keep yourself safe from the terrors emerging there. Someone used a lot of canisters if there are terrors on the mainland. This is a terrible idea. Just all of this. Oh, man. Nice little island there. Anyway, let's putter over. Difficult journey, piloting the small skiff over choppy seas. However, you managed to navigate it to Fort Wilton, the second largest settlement on Donald's Island. Donald's Island was the first of the Ashnaas to be settled over a century ago. First, it was like Greenwood Isle, mined for its crystals. However, after the mines were played out, Donald's Island found a second colony as a home for craftsmen. When the mines were still functional, many crystal workers, alchemists, and wand makers came to the island. When the crystal stopped coming out of the ground, they started importing them. They worked in isolation at first until the quality of their craftsmanship became widely known. Now Donald's Island is the largest concentration of mages and shapers for hundreds of miles, even accounting nearby Terrestria. You feel greatly relieved finally have gotten here. You hope that Lord Rawl and his powerful circle of shapers can succeed in keeping the chaos at bay. Your hopes don't last long. It's not really a fort anymore. It's a cluster of stores and workshops around the old stone wall that used to protect the settlement. You're inside the old wall now, and it looks like the fort has been attacked recently. It smells like it, too. The old stone wall has scorch marks on it. You can smell sulfur and blood in the air. You also see a battle alpha. Because of the months of quarantine, inactive docks have been converted to a punishment place for creations. The battle alpha, furious and rogue, is chained up before you. It sees you watching it. It snarls. Then it quickly quiets down. Here's what you hear, the sound of boots on cobblestones getting closer. Walk up behind the Alpha as it begins to vainly struggle to break its chains. The middle warrior says, I am Captain Celeste, the defensive corps of Fort Wilton. This Alpha has been found to be infected and rogue. It's been deemed necessary to dispose of it. Does anyone wish to speak for it? Its continued utility. This doesn't give anyone a chance to speak. Clearly, she doesn't expect anyone to say anything on behalf of the clearly maddened creature. There seems about to be say something, but she's not fast enough. Fast, smooth motion. The captain raises her baton to the back of the Alpha's head. Harsh. Business is done. Captain Celeste approaches you. She had already heard of your arrival, of course. She clearly felt the Alpha needed to be dealt with first. She looks upset. Killing creations is not something she enjoys doing. She bows to you. Greetings, Shaper. Welcome to Donald's Island. I was told you might arrive. I'm glad. We could definitely use another Shaper to help us. I'm sorry you had to witness the ugliness with that battle Alpha. It needs to be done. More and more these days. Why did it need to be destroyed? Went rogue. An increasingly common problem. Tried to kill one of the human soldiers. Came close to succeeding. Might have been able to regain control, but the odds didn't seem good, and we were putting ourselves at risk didn't seem like the right option, so the order was given, she sighs. You mean it has to be done more often? I think that the commander would want to discuss that himself. He's in the inn. Couldn't you have done anything to try to regain control of it? She's very irritated by this, just when she bites her lip. It takes her a moment to regain her composure. She says, I did not want to slay that creature. If you've made a problem with what happened, you should speak with the Shaper who made it. I am not to blame for what it tried to do. This is not important. I was sent to welcome you and to tell you what you need to know. I will do so. What do I need to know? the quarantine, nobody from Afi Island is allowed to leave the docks without permission and inspection. I am sure you understand the risks involved with introducing poorly made creations to the situation, so this rule applies doubly to shapers. I don't think you will have any trouble, but first speak to the customs agent and the commander and you should be fine. Okay. Same to you, shaper. If you need to know anything else, please track me down. I will be by the inn. Genuinely seems to wish you well. She must not know that you assisted the rebels on Harmony Isle. If she did, you don't doubt your welcome would be very different. Nothing seems to be stopping me from just sailing back, which is good, because I didn't really fully explore that place. Slither, you're so fragile, and I have not enough essence. Well, anyway, that will do for now. Man, that was a lot of recording. You guys, you all take care, okay? I will talk to you later. When we come back, I'll probably putter back to Harmony Isle and explore the areas that aren't related to being a loyalist. I just want to finish that off before we start exploring here. But I just, it's like been 4 freaking hours and I want to stop. So, take care, y'all. I will see you later.